So what I want to be able to do in this few moments of time is hit the core of how to, because I'm an executioner. I want to see stuff done. If we're going to be in the kingdom of God, let's build something. Let's build something. Let's make something happen. And so one of the things I want to begin to do is we're going to talk about how to execute. How to execute. There's one thing to know is knowledge. There's another thing to have understanding. Knowledge looks at a tree and says, information, that's a tree. But most of us don't recognize that many of us are filled with knowledge. We're spewing knowledge. You've been to colleges, universities, but you still can't get a job. Still can't get a job that provides your needs. Still can't make life work. You have plenty of knowledge, brilliant, A student, but your life has not measured more than even a C or D student in life. You have knowledge, but the knowledge in itself is insufficient. We employ a large number of people, and they're coming, graduating out of colleges all day, often coming to us. They have knowledge, but they lack something. And this is the something I want to talk to you about. Knowledge of that being a tree, I can starve to death. I can still die. Knowledge must convert. Hear the word convert. Say convert with me. You must convert knowledge to the next level of understanding. Understanding would look at the tree and say, that's a tree with fruit on it. It would save one's life, and I can begin to go and teach the rest of the world about how this tree over there with fruit can save one's life and could bring life and bring health and energy to one's body and still myself die. And many of us, we have knowledge, we have understanding, we become teachers, we teach our children, we teach others. You're wise people are teaching, but you're perishing. And so knowledge and understanding isn't sufficient to bring life, even in the kingdom of God. It must convert, it must say convert. It must convert to the third level. Knowledge and understanding have no value until it converts to the third level of wisdom. Wisdom is that which the church most lacks. If you could just see it in the gestalt of the atmosphere being spiritual, but you can't convert it to make stuff happen on earth, there's a bridge gap. There's a breach between the kingdom and the earth. And God prayed that there would be a bridge, and the church is to be the bridge between the psychosoma, between the invisible physical aspect of reality. And so it must convert to wisdom. Wisdom is the ability to execute. Many of us have executed. But God said the lukewarm he'll spew out of his mouth, either be hot or cold. That when you've been called to the kingdom of God, there becomes a warrior spirit. So if you see me standing here hollering and shouting, this is not an act. Those of you who know Coach, this is who I am. Because you are to be an epistle. You're not to talk the word, you're to be it. And so one of the things that we talked about is wisdom. Wisdom different from knowledge and understanding. Wisdom is eating a food. If I eat a carrot, as long as it's in my cheeks, it's a carrot. As long as I chew it, masticate it, it's still a carrot. Understanding. But once I swallow the carrot, my body and that carrot are genetically responsive. That carrot no longer becomes carrot. That carrot becomes my epidermis. It becomes my eyes. It becomes my vision. It becomes me. So in other words, you can tell what I've eaten. Don't judge me too harshly. So you can tell what I've eaten by what you see. And so it is with the kingdom of God. You are what you eat. And those who are wise can see what you eat and can tell the health of what you have been eating. Now, if I eat and I don't convert, say convert. What was meant to be a blessing will become a curse. Many of us have been sitting in the pews and we haven't been converting. And so what has been a blessing, the kingdom, the word of God, because we haven't converted it, it becomes a curse. And so what would you call this hanging on my side right here? What would you call it? See, some of you said it was fat. No, it's potential energy. It is energy that has not been converted. And so it is that many of us, God has blessed you with knowledge and understanding, but you haven't converted it, and it has become a curse. And so again, the church is to be a converting machine, a conversion where the word of God becomes, where logos become rhema. So if I could have my wife read for us for a moment, I always like to include my beautiful bride, Hattie. You won't see Al without Hattie. So where we're going to begin to do is convert. Are you ready to convert with me? I want you to take out pencil and paper because we only have a short time and we're going to convert today. You may not get it all, but you're going to get it. You may not get it all, but you're going to get it. How many understand what I just said? Do you see what I say? All right.